So I'm really hyper right now. Just went to see Captain America: The Winter Soldier. Wow. Like, I'm gonna try and make this review as quick as possible, because otherwise I'll just rant on. I love the fact that this film had a totally different feel to it than like any of the other films we've seen so far. A very dark feeling to it. The action scenes were great. Just the storylines, the plot twists, loved it. From this point on, I'll say spoilers warning. One of the things that made me like go mad was just obviously the mention of Stephen Strange and this kind of acknowledgement that actually there were quite a lot of people like Captain America out there. I thought that was absolutely brilliant. There's probably so many Easter eggs that I missed because when they're scanning and trying to find all the targets, I was trying to read names and see if there was anyone else that I recognized. I thought it was nice how there was like really just subtle humor in it. It's like I said, the fight scenes were good. Like, I personally felt there was too many like just fight scenes. You know, there was so a lot of it, but I thought they were very well done. Finally got to see Captain America as a proper badass. It's like I said, there's a concept of who can you trust, and throughout the film, we don't know who is good, who is bad, which I love. I love how you just sort of doubted characters. I mean, one thing that confused me. Obviously, in the film, we see the end of S.H.I.E.L.D. and what have you. But Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is supposed to sort of go along with what's happening in the films. It might just be the fact that, obviously, in the UK, we're behind with Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. But to me, it would seem really stupid if Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. carries on now, the TV show, when in the cinematic universe it's been established that S.H.I.E.L.D.'s sort of gone. So that was my only sort of issue with it. Of course, this the best post-credit scene of all time, because of course we see Hydra and they've got the Loki's staff thingy from the Avengers. I thought that was going to be it, and I was about to kick off because I thought, wow, you've given us nothing new whatsoever. And then, of course, they talk about the twins. At first, I was looking and my brain wasn't probably working, and I thought, who the hell's that? And then, obviously, on the left, we see a boy zooming around his cell, and on the right, we see a girl and she's hovering cubes. And then I thought, this is amazing because it's Scarlet Witch and Quicksilver. Because, of course, they're a massive part of the Avengers. We will also see Quicksilver in X-Men, but quite frankly, I'm starting to disregard the X-Men films. It's just getting stupid. I really think they need a reboot. But apparently, Fox has the rights to, obviously, Magneto and the word mutant and all the rest of it, so it'll be interesting to see what their origin story will be. But yeah, Captain America, absolutely great. Really, really loved it. They've just stepped up completely. Like, Thor: The Dark World was amazing, Captain America's amazing, Spider-Man comes out soon, Amazing Spider-Man 2, I'm looking forward to that. Then we've got X-Men Days of Futures Past coming out, and then in the summer, Guardians of the Galaxy, which should be awesome. Probably have to give this a 9 out of 10. It's like I said, there was just the only reason it drops a point is perhaps too much action. And obviously, it's like I said, the whole Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. thing. And then obviously, we have the Winter Soldier. I forgot to mention this. You got the Winter Soldier. I already knew it was Bucky because I read the comics. But I think that whole story was just so interesting because it was almost like it was like Cap's main story. And that. And then we get this kind of, we're left thinking, well, Bucky seems to be a good guy, but seems quite confused at the end of the film. and you actually see him go to the Smithsonian and have a look at his own World War II profile in the right after the credits. I thought that was really interesting as well. And it looks like Cap wants to further look for the Winter Soldier, so we've got a nice storyline now set up for Cap. And yeah, there was just so much character development and getting a proper look at Nick Fury and Black Widow and stuff. Falcon, absolutely loved Falcon. I thought he was really good. Obviously, he's not the classic Falcon, but with these films, obviously the comics were written so long ago that the films are updating it into the here and now. So the fact that we have Twitter mentioned in the film and, you know, iTunes and stuff, thought that was great. I think that's everything really that I wanted to talk about. So yeah, thanks guys.